The amount of JavaScript you ship to your users is one of the most important metrics when it comes to your site's performance. It can be the difference between a site that feels snappy and fast versus sluggish and slow, which directly impacts your users. Today, I'm going to show an approach you can use in your SvelteKit projects to reduce the amount of JavaScript you use. And I will show you a tool that can visualize all the JavaScript libraries that you're shipping to your client, so that you can figure out what you should keep and what you should optimize away. Let's get on with the video. So just a few days ago, Svelte 5 was released. So we have this like brand new, beautiful site. And we're of course gonna use the new CLI tool called SV to create our SvelteKit project to play around in. Let's go ahead and do that now. I'm just gonna paste the command here to create a new project. We're gonna call it SvelteKit Bundles. And it's going to ask me what kind of template I want. Let's go with minimal. Yes, let's use TypeScript. Let's not install any of this stuff here. And I'm going to be using npm for this. And this new tool is so beautiful, and it also installs the dependencies for you. That's just fantastic. This is actually the first time I'm trying it. All right. So let's go ahead and do the steps that it's asking me for to go into the folder. Init the project with Git, and then I'm going to go ahead and open it with my terminal with VS Code. All right, so now that we've got our new project, the first thing that we are going to do is we're going to install this tool that visualizes the bundles for us, so we can start by looking into the default sort of bundles you get. So the tool that I use for this is this tool called Rollup Plugin Visualizer. Now it says Rollup, and the Vite uses Rollup under the hood, so that's why it works. So in your brand new project, we're gonna go ahead and install it. There we go. And then we are going to configure it as it is instructed. So the way we do it is we go to the Vite config and we import it like that. And then in the plugins array, we just go ahead and add the visualizer. And I think we can add it either before or after SvelteKit. I don't think it matters. And then we also need to add just a little bit of config. So I'm going to go ahead and add this config here. There's actually a specific section here which says usage with SvelteKit. And what it's telling you to do is add this little config object with emit file true, and file name should be stats.html. All right. Now that I've done that, let's go ahead and run it. Or rather, let's go ahead and build the project and let's see what we get. So by default, if you don't use any specific adapter, so using like adapter auto, which you get out of the box, right? You get this like .SvelteKit folder. If you use adapter node, you get this build folder. And for other adapters, it kind of depends on the adapter, what you get. So the way it works is that you have to go into the SvelteKit folder, which represents your build file. And then you go to output client. And here you'll have this stats.html file. So let's go ahead and take a look at that file. And this is what it looks like. So here you can see all the different JavaScript bundles that make up your site. These are all like default kind of SvelteKit things. So this is not something that is abnormal, which is why I wanted to show it first before we start adding our own stuff into here. And because I opened this from the client folder, this is obviously only going to be the client stuff, which is what we're interested in because we want to reduce the amount of JavaScript we are sending to the client. And just to kind of finish it off, let's just go ahead and open the site up and see what we get. And what we got was the default template. So everything is looking great. All right, now let's assume that we're using a library on the site. So I'm going to pick a library that is known to be like a little bit heavy and that is also quite commonly used on many sites. And that library that I picked for this demo is moment.js. So moment.js is a date library, and we're basically gonna use it like you would maybe normally use it in a project. So I'm gonna first go ahead and install it. Right, that's installed. And I'm gonna, let's start with using it on our plus page.svelte. This is the most basic sort of usage where you just import it into a component. Let's go ahead and see how the API looks for that. So I guess you import moment from moment, and then you do something like on mount. We're just going to keep it simple and just do it on mount. We're gonna set a variable to the current date according to moment. And we're gonna print it. There we go. All right, now let's see how that looks. All right, and we got our date. And the date will not refresh by default, but it will refresh whenever we reload the page. So that looks great. Now let's see how that has impacted our bundles. So I'm gonna build again, and I'm gonna open the stats file again. And there we have it. So we got this extra big bundle here. And if we, it's maybe a little bit small, sorry for that, but like you can see here that this huge kind of greenish box here represents moments. So now moments represents basically like 3/4 of our project bundle size. That's not great, right? So let's see what we can do about that. So, you know, normally you don't load data like this. Usually you don't do it in a plus page.svelte, right? You would do it in a load function typically. So there's two types of load functions. We're going to start by using the plus page.ts function. Now, this function runs both on the client and on the server. So we're going to see how that impacts the bundle size. So let me go ahead and look up the load function in the new brand new docs. And I'm just going to borrow a example here. There we go. And I'm basically going to move the date setup into here. So I'm going to go ahead and do this. So I'm going to say, I'm going to return date is going to be the date. And then I'm going to move the import statement as well. And we're going to remove all this on mount stuff. And we are going to instead be using, since we're using Svelte 5 now, not export let data, but we're going to use const props. Const data is props. There we go. And then this should be data.date. And the moment import goes here. And let's see here what we get. Yeah, so it took a second there, but it figured everything out. All right. Let's see how that works out. Whoa, we got this error. All right, let's have a look here at what's going on. I messed up the syntax. Happens to the best of us. All right, there we go. So we got the same thing now, and we've moved the data loading into a load function. We use the universal load function. All right, now let's build and see what happens. And you can think about it while it's building. What do you think is going to happen? Opening the client build again here. All right, nothing happened, right? And if you suspected this, then congratulations. And the reason that nothing happens is because, as I mentioned, the universal load function runs on both the client and on the server. So since it reruns on the client, that necessitates it to actually include all of the libraries you use in it in the client-side bundle. That's not great. So what we could try instead is to use the server function. So I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna just rename this to page.server.ts because the format is the same. The type is, I think, page server load instead. There we go. And we run npm run dev, which is very important when you work with these generated types, and then eventually it clears up. All right, so ideally everything should be just the same now, right? We don't need to change anything here because the data will just come from the server instead. All right, and it still works. Now we try to build again, and let's see what happened with the bundle. All right, it disappeared, right? The reason for this is because when you have a server function, it actually only, as the name implies, it only executes on the server. So instead of getting like the whole library sent over to the user, and then the user's browser has to download it, parse it, execute it, what happens instead is that we only just literally send that like one string, which represents the date from the server to the client, and the client renders it. So if we kind of, we can even actually look at how that looks, because if we look in the page source for this page, and then in the output, so we get the server output here, which we would have gotten with the universal function as well. But then if we scroll down here a little bit, we have this const data array, and here you see this date and you see just the string. So as we saw, that we managed to completely eliminate moment.js from the client bundle, which is great. And the way I usually basically do this is when I kind of am in the ending stages of a project and I'm sort of doing a little bit of polish, I basically like use this Rollup Plugin Visualizer, and I hunt for these libraries that they ideally don't want to ship to the client. So any kind of box that is big and imposing is an opportunity to refactor. And usually you can actually refactor it in a way so that they come from the, so the data comes from the server instead, which as we see here makes a huge difference in bundle size. So just for a little bit of a comparison, let's also compare the actual bundle size, like how big do the bundles get. So like I'm gonna go ahead and build the site, and we're gonna see here we have this, we're gonna look at the client, we have this one main entry bundle that is 28 kilobytes, we have the runtime that is 11, we have the app itself that is 10 kilobytes. So that's kind of like what we're working with here. Now let me go back again and change this to the universal function where we would ship this to the client. There we go. Gonna just change the types again. There, and then let's build again and kind of compare. All right. So now we got this brand new bundle. So before we had the entry, 28K, runtime, 11K, and the app, which was 10K. Now we got this additional nodes bundle that was generated by SvelteKit. SvelteKit does this internally. It kind of like tries to move all the bundles into correct places so that you can optimize so you don't load anything unnecessary when you're going to a specific rack. But basically we got this extra bundle of about 61 kilobytes. And that's, you know, that's not so huge in itself, but you know, you have one library and then you add another one, and then at the end, you know, with all these different libraries you're using, you have a bunch of them, and then that's when you have a problem. So I hope you liked this video. I would love to hear if you've already been doing this in your projects, and or if you haven't, if you try this and if you find any libraries that you could optimize in this way to make them not be shipped to the client. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.